Good afternoon, everyone. Today is Friday, 17
November 2017. Minus 8 in Brandon, as well as Dauphin. Minus 10 in the Paws, as well as Flint Bond. Minus 13 in Thompson and Churchill. Minus 9. Welcome to Laugh Out Loud. You're listening to Canada's premier comedy show, broadcast on CBC Radio 1, Sirius XM, and available on the CBC Radio app. My name is Ali Hassan. After many moves away from the city of Calgary, we finally went back there a few weeks ago. And we're so happy we did. With the help of a dozen terrific performers, we produced some great comedy that you'll be hearing over the coming weeks and months. But it all starts today. First comedian we're going to play got their start performing in karaoke bars. Hey, wherever there's a microphone, you will find us. My favorite thing about her is that when a booking agent told her that she shouldn't tell her jokes because she is a female, she used that as motivation and signed on to work with a national comedy club. That was 10 years ago. Thank you, misguided booking agent. From the stage at Yuck Yucks at the Elbow River Casino in Calgary, let's kick things off with Lisa Bing.
I moved down here about 4 years ago. Just decided one day I wanted to live here.
Came out here about
20. Realized you guys kind of talk funny. Yeah.
I've never met people talk so slowly before in my life. It was a little weird for me. I didn't understand it. I got a job in a shop with a bunch of guys. That was interesting. Because they liked the way to make fun of the way I spoke, right? And they wouldn't make fun of stuff I said. Just random stuff. They wanted me to say specific words. So every day they'd ask me the same question. Hey Lisa, how'd you get to work this morning?
I drove.
Oh yeah? What'd you drive?
My car.
Really? Every day with this question behind you, you know I drove the car. Because my car sits in the parking lot next to your piece of garbage car.
Every day.
So every day I would drive to work and I'd practice. Car. Car. Car.
So eventually I got really good at stone and I learned to speak English.
It's weird for me because, you know, I've been to other newbies, right? The ones with a real strong accent. You know, it's a little difficult to understand them, and I worked with one of them. And the boys would say, how come you don't sound like that guy? I think that nobody sounds like that guy. I don't even think that's an accent. I'm pretty good at speech impediment.
Stop making fun of it. It's rude.
At the school over there on 6th,
them, right?
They say it's hard to do cut hair around the ears. Do you think?
Yes, if start to learn is difficult, but then know how to cut, right? It's not difficult. It's hard for me, also a lot of people, but for right now I am okay. Because I know already how to cut.
Oh, okay.
You don't know how to cut, you should be this out. And maybe sometimes we cut that, yeah.
Oh.
The first time I cut,
we didn't think that all the way through, you know?
Little bit, this scared bit of my sister.
I understood.
That because it takes, but for right now, no. If you not happy again, because I know how to cut and then I more expert, so I will never cut like that. You know?
Mm-hmm.
But if you have him, then the first start to learn
my very first job was Bergen.
Oh.
And when I first started working there, it was a little small town just outside of Edmonton. Everybody knew each other. And I'm working in the bar, and of course everybody in the town wants to meet you, the regulars, right? You come in the bar every day, you know everybody. They come up, hey, where are you from? I'm from Newfoundland.
Oh, you
see,
know, you like to drink, hey?
Yeah.
Well, that's sour.
Around the area.
See, look, that's for you. Can you see it?
You take your
it's good enough like that?
And go sit in the corner, okay?
Well, okay.
Great. Mine out. Hey, all guys, I have a little bit of advice. Don't go into the bar and ask to make a mojito. That's probably not smart, right? Guys,
you cut it around the ear? Right here?
No, I can't make a mojito.
Right here.
You don't go into
You want it out or over, right? Okay, I give you.
Okay, here, broken man, we're a pair of steel toe loop, what are you doing? But that's where I met the newbies first, the other newbies, I was working in this bar and this newbie came in one night. And he heard me speak, so he got very excited, right? You know, imagine how rare it is to find another Newfoundlander in Alberta. He was so excited, he started trying to get my attention. Hi, muscles. Oh, hi, muscles. Muscles. Oh, no, muscles. Hi, yeah, no, you, yeah. Partner, yeah. Muscles, muscles. I'm thinking, oh my God, I have to talk to this guy. So I go over and I say, yes, how can I help you? He says, now, muscles, where are you from now, eh? And I said, I'm from Newfoundland. I know what you think, because I'm bilingual. And at that point, he just launches into his whole life story. I guess we're married now where he's from. I don't know how it works out there. Seems to be a lot of laws and stuff. So he just tells me his life story. Just immediately takes one breath, gives her. Oh, yeah. Me and the best life. Me and the best life. That was it now. Back home, sir. That was another one. So I asked him, I was like, how long have you been here? He was, oh, I don't know, mostly about 10 years, I don't know, 10 years? 10 years you've been here? Really? Jesus Murphy, are you even trying? So no wonder y'all think we're stupid. I did learn very quickly, you can't be newbie drunk in Alberta. And I have friends who say, that's silly, you can absolutely be newbie drunk in Alberta. No, you cannot. I've tried it, didn't end well. And I should tell you that newbie drunk is a thing that doesn't happen in Newfoundland, doesn't exist, because there's no such thing as newbie drunk in Newfoundland. It's just, it's Tuesday. It's Tuesday. That's it.
Have you ever used that before?
But I got newbie drunk.
Did you ever use that before?
I knew it. A woman, she like it. But some women, she don't like. It depends.
Tell me that's not Tom over there peeing in the corner. Follow boy, go on, babe, leave him alone. At least he's using that plank this time.
It depends on what kind of haircut.
In Alberta, people phone the cops. Not cool, guys. I got newbie drunk at a work function. Yeah, work function, which in my defense didn't know newbie drunk was a thing, just assuming I was drinking with grown men.
And yeah. I find a job for right now. I at least I work just about 40 hours per month.
Where are you going to work?
I apply the place that they need someone and get painted. But someone they won't, right? Someone they won't get painted.
That's it.
Apply the place that they want to get painted. Some place they just want experienced people. But I pray to God that
I didn't know
the right place for me.
So you're going to be a hairdresser?
Yep.
Yeah.
So the company decides to have the party at noon, so they figured if they had it at noon.
I paid 9,000.
How much?
9,000.
$9?
$9,000.
$9,000. Oh.
A lot of money, right?
Yeah.
And 3 years that I spend my time for 3 years.
Yeah.
If I spend 9,000 and 3 years with university, I will get job with many places already. I can get many places to work, even open office already. But for right now, I cannot give up hair styling because I have a lot of my tool. I have knowledge enough to work that I cannot to say goodbye, you know? Mm-hmm. I cannot say like that. So I have to buy some play to hide me and...
Ma'am, I'm gonna need you to pour out that drink. So I chug it.